I'm in this town over here, and let me go this way. Yeah, so last night before I had to shut down, I had a I was coming down this road. Which is the three, Route 3 or whatever. So, it's a little town, right? I was coming down this hill, which is more steep. It doesn't look steep. I had to go this way. There's a hill up ahead on that Route 3. Even through my maneuvering, I was not able to make it up. It was that steep. So, so luckily I had a fellow. He had them yellow lights. He had a pickup truck with them caution yellow lights. He was right behind me, luckily, so he helped me back up. So I backed up and turned around. So I need to find some place to park. You know, so he was like, they got a spot next to the railroad. But towards going back where I came from. And I remembered up there, I was like, nah, I don't know if I really want to go back up there. But I didn't have to go up the hill. Like, that spot was like right next to that railroad right there. I didn't have to go up the hill. So I was able to find a spot to spend the night, and I was good. So two directions. Two, three directions. I know I'm not able to go around because of these hills, this mountain. I'm gonna show you on the map. Like, these mountains ain't no joke. Look where I'm at. So I just walked towards one of the routes I'm gonna take, which is like the 116 or something. And so there was like a fire department and a police department or something, sheriff's department or whatever. I just went and asked of how steep the hill was. So yeah, they did tell me that one hill I was trying to get up, usually the trucks, I usually have an issue getting up there, but this one I'm going up towards, I shouldn't have an issue, so we'll see what happens. Yeah, I mean, I ain't got no choice. This is where I ended up. Like, as you can see, I don't know if you can see it, but all this right here is mountain. Look at that. So I was coming from the two up on the mountains, man. Mountains. Twin Mountain. So I ended up. After that accident, there was an accident last night. It's coming this way and stopped right there. The accident been there like an hour and a half. Almost 2 hours. So after it cleared up, My time was running out. So I looked on Trucker Path. I saw there was a truck stop right here. I was going to try to stop right here. Right there. And rest up for the night. So I made that right. And I was going here. Got stuck like right there. Couldn't make it up. So I had to back out. So luckily there's that spot near the railroad I just showed you. That's where I'm at. So I had to walk over here. That's where I'm gonna try to take the 116 to go up to try to get to 93. So that's my only way right here. I'm hoping I'll be all right. That spot I was telling you about. Yeah, it was pretty steep. I almost stalled. I had to stop on the hill, but I wasn't taking no for an answer. No for an answer. So I'm on another mountain right now. So I'm going about 30 miles an hour. Pretty steep. So I'm in eighth gear. We're on 93, Interstate 93, just past the border into Vermont. And I'm pretty sure I'm gonna meet up with 91 pretty soon and take north to Derby. But, yeah, challenging. Look at this semi just coming out up the mountain like no problem. Look at this. I'm gonna see, I think it's going like 80 miles an hour uphill. Kenworth. Well, it's a gorgeous day out. Gorgeous day. So, yep, I'm headed to my destination. Appointment time's been changed to 6 o'clock or 1800 hours. My gear has been acting different ever since I went uphill and I had to fight with them gears. Like I was going up that mountain like fifth gear. Now I'm trying to change it to 10th. Junk is acting weird. I gotta get it checked out. Man. Got another Walmart it's gotta go to.
Hopefully not this one.
Yeah.
Maybe that was one of the little
too. I don't know if he gets here before I leave, I might help. I know it ain't no joke moving this stuff around. I think we got back here 1, 2. Yeah. Berkeley, leaving Derby, Vermont. Looking for a truck stop to stop at for the rest of the night. I'm officially unloaded from the Walmart. And the unload went well. I was helping a fellow primer. Her truck had to get unloaded first. So assuming that supposedly they had the driver supposed to unload, not sure. Haven't looked at the bills. She said she's gonna do it. Walmart people were there, so they did it. It was hard. I was there helping. So I was in the back of the trailer and we were lifting some heavy stuff.
Boost up to a whole nother domain. Out the bottle, I'm a living proof too. And compromising half a million on the pool. Drug houses found, looking.
Put it towards the end of the trailer and had the forklift move it. After it got unloaded, I went inside Walmart, got a few things, and then after I left. So I don't know what time it is. I went to a truck stop that I thought it was a truck stop, it wasn't. It was like 1 mile away from Walmart. There was no trucks there, no parking. So I'm off duty right now. And I'm on 91 southbound, about 50 miles south. Got a couple of truck stops down there. I'm gonna see if I can get me a shower. Favorite word, shower. Yeah. I'm not even on the strip, but okay. That buzzer you hear there, it's a sensor. Normally when you touch lines or going off course of the road, you'll have your buzzer. But yeah. Trailer is empty. It's super light. I feel like a feather. Like I'm going up these mountains with a breeze. It's like so nice. No weight. Yeah. No weight at all. So smooth. And I'm waiting to get something to eat. I'm starving. What I had this morning, I had some coffee, small cup of coffee, and some Dunkin' Donuts. It was like a sausage, egg and cheese on an English muffin. Trying to keep away from that sausage, man. Everywhere you go, it's either bacon, sausage, or ham.
Cruising Biscayne, get fine. Drive bump, that's a liability, bit fine. Hit the gas, yeah. Boosting my adrenaline, bit fine. Percocet, yeah. Molly Percocet, bit fine. Percocet, yeah. Molly Percocet.
Man. So I went to Walmart, I got me some turkey and some bread. Got some mayo here and there. I got some cheese. Got some water. Iced coffee and stuff like that. Peanut butter, jelly, stuff like that. Well, I'm on the road, man. I'm gonna stop spending expensive amount of dollars at these places.
I do eat a lot of Subway. I eat those wraps, like a rotisserie chicken wrap from Subway. Half the time I have the steak wrap. If I get to a buffet, like a Chinese buffet, I'll go all out. But yeah, so that was pretty much my day. Thanks for joining me on the journey. Yeah, I feel like I got some things I can talk about, but I'll save it for the next video. Till then, thanks for commenting, liking, and subscribing to Prime Trucker Steve. Later.